YouTube once again, Gabriel Joseph hitting you with another video. Only this video, I'm at a building that been abandoned for some time now. And basically, I had to look into this building because I have dreams and aspirations of having a youth center one day. And so instead of me doing what I've been doing the last 5 years, was just driving past buildings saying, hey, that could be my youth center. Hey, that could be it too. Hey, you seen that one over there? And then I ain't do nothing with it. And so this one here, to me, is perfect. I mean, perfect. So perfect, I couldn't even just sit on it like the others. You see behind me, nothing but docks. This is where semis and big trucks can pull up to let in equipment and stuff like that. You see this behind me over here? Nothing but field. Good big field for the kids to play the games, the kickball, the soccer ball, the baseball, the t-ball, the football, all the balls, okay? There's nothing but balls in this field right here, all right? So what I'm gonna do, I already talked to the owner, the seller. Well, I talked to the seller. And what they want ain't even out of hand, you know? The thing is what's going on the inside? What does this place need? Will it pass inspections? Stuff like that. That is pretty much what I'm worried about right now. And so, I'm gonna take you to the front. I went all the way to the back. I don't know why I left my coat in the car. It's like 30 degrees outside. So, what I'm doing is, I'm walking the property right now. And I'm also claiming it. I'm not just gonna walk in and say, ooh, I really like this. Hey, this would be really nice. No, I'm gonna claim it. I'm gonna say right now that this is my property for my youth center, okay? Look at this right here. This is the entrance, okay? You dress it up, you know? Throw your big logo up there on top right there. Like right there, see that logo there? The kids come in, the parents can pull in right here. They can get dropped off. Look at all this parking right here. You got a busy street, and the building's far from the street, so kids won't be getting, you know, too close to the traffic and stuff like that. But here you go. I've never walked this close. I never even got this close, y'all. I just drove past it a few times. I saw the number, and I called and inquired. So this is it. Looks like you got some rooms that look like they can be classrooms, a little daycare or a nursery or something like that. But I'm gonna walk around this whole building and claim this building. This is my building. This right here is my building right now. Right now, okay? Right now. Not later, not next year. Now. 373270. You see it? It's all me. The youth center. I said the name, but I ain't got the name trademarked yet. Once I trademark that name, you'll hear about it a lot. A lot. Look at this. Nothing but parking. Nothing but room for buses to come drop off these kids after school. I even got works in the plans with the schools in this neighborhood. Nothing but parking. Nothing but parking around this whole thing. And then behind me here, you have the Metra. The Metra stop. It's a train stop right here. So kids from all over can easily access or come to this building easily. It's so accessible. Kids can easily come here. It's not a problem. From school buses, it's schools all around here. High schools, elementaries, junior highs, schools all around here. All you gotta do, link up with the schools and the buses and get those bus companies to stop at those schools and then add this as a route, meaning you have those buses stop here to drop off kids, okay? We house these kids, we learn different things, they play different games, they do different things until it's time for their parents to come pick them up, okay? This right here is getting kids off these streets, and this is also teaching kids what they're not learning in school. Let's be real. How many of us have actually used trigonometry, calculus? Who's out here multiplying letters and trying to get variables and all this stuff? I mean, I get it, it's all beneficial, but at the end of the day, I want to teach kids stuff that they can learn right now and apply it to their life right now. That's what I'm gonna plan to do. That's what I plan to do, and that's what I'm gonna do. You gotta understand, it's more than just a building to put kids in. It's a whole curriculum involved. It's programs, multiple programs involved for kids depending on what they got going on or what type of help they may need, okay? So stay tuned. I'm gonna add a link to this, to the GoFundMe, so everybody can pitch in and help out your boy, you know, because I'm trying to help out the younger generations. The younger generations are our future leaders, our future politicians. If you don't like the politicians that we have in office now, you don't like what they're saying, what they're doing, their policies and stuff like that, understand, they were raised by a generation before them, and a lot of their viewpoints come from that generation, how they were raised. We want to raise up a different type of generation, all right? So let's help these kids, these inner city youths. Let's show them how they're being targeted. Let's show them ways of getting out of the trap, okay? Forget all that trap house talk. That's dead. The new wave is education. And I mean education that you don't learn in school. The new wave is learning about your spirituality. The new wave is upgrading your way of thinking so that you only think positive and that you never think negative. I don't care if you got a crackhead house, a crack house across the street. There are ways that you can still think positive in all of that, okay? Look at it in a different way. Look at it as somebody seeing that and not being intrigued, like, oh, that's how I want to grow up. But somebody's going to look at that and say, I want to grow up and be as far away from that as possible. And guess what that is? That motivated them. That crackhead, that crack house just motivated this person to go get an education. You see, everything is positive. It just may be viewed in a negative light. All right, I'm back out here. Walking to the car. You got to say it is so. This is my property for my youth center right now. All right, I'm gone, I'm out of here. It's cold, I did my walk, I did my affirmations, I spoke it into existence, and now it's just a matter of letting the universe make it happen. But I'm not gonna sit still and not do nothing. I'm still gonna do my part in trying to make sure that I get this building, okay? Faith without works is void, all right? What you're seeing now is faith and works, all right? Well, you may not see the works that much, but right now you see me doing my affirmations. You see me having faith that this will be mine, all right? So have faith with me. We're two or three gather together, and I'm sure you're watching, so just join in and gather together and agree with me, all right? All right. Again, like, subscribe, share, because sharing is caring. Gabriel Joseph here. Whew, not a mastering life video, but a positive video. Just to let you know what I'm doing out here and what you could be doing out here. Get off the streets, get out of this regular way of thinking, all right? There's a lot of businesses and companies out here, and guess what? Somebody had to be above average to create those businesses and companies. Somebody created Uber. They wasn't thinking about playing PlayStation all day, all right? Keep that in mind. Gabriel Joseph again. I'm out of here. Peace out.